appears the wall gave way.
It was big news when it happened. After all, the integrity of the entire Westside Road interchange was in question when the wall came down. An embarrassment for all involved, but most importantly, a major headache for the motoring public, some taking as much as 4 hours to get home as the Ministry of Transportation improvised to ease the congestion.
We are working as hard as we can to ensure that traffic flows as smoothly as possible.
After months of repair, the Westside Road interchange reopened to traffic Monday. But unless you use the overpass, you really wouldn't notice a difference. Traffic is still down to two lanes instead of three and will stay that way for a while. But it's a step in the right direction as crews continue to repair the retaining walls on both sides of the structure. At the time, the big question was, what caused the collapse?
Again, it's very hard to say,
but we haven't got a conclusive answer yet. That'll take some time.
What we know is that the initial failure was caused from the failure of the metal in the fascia walls. So there's some still ongoing final reports that need to be completed, but that was the basis of the failure.
Problem solved, and the taxpayer apparently isn't picking up the tab. Time to move on to phase two of the Westside Road overpass project, which includes the construction of an underpass at Nancy Way.
We'll see that excavation start in the next week, probably.
In West Kelowna, Kelly Hayes, Castanet Media.